What's going on YouTube? Welcome to the channel. Thanks for checking out the channel. And if you're new to the channel, make sure you hit that like button, you hit the subscribe button, you hit the notify button, where we're always dropping new Toyota Tacoma content. So let's just jump into it, guys. I finally got some new tires. Yes, finally got new tires. And as you guys are pretty much aware of, if you have a Tacoma, a third gen Tacoma, it came on an off-road at least. If you had an off-road, it typically comes on, they come on 265, 70, R16. So if you have an off-road or a pro, that's the tire size you're gonna get. So if you have a sport, you're gonna get 265, 70. You're gonna get 265, 65, 17, sorry. And if you have a 4Runner, because you know you can put these wheels on 4Runners as well, or 4Runner wheels on Tacomas. You can't put Tacoma wheels on 4Runners, but if you had a 4Runner, typically they come on 265, 70, R17. But anyway, these came on 265, 70, R16. And what I did was I upgraded to 265, 75, R16. And the reason why I decided to go with this size is because I do have the TRD Pro, so it is a little bit higher than the factory TRD off-road or sport, so it sits a little bit higher. But the biggest thing is, like, if you were to go 285s, which a lot of people like to go with, and which I really would have liked to go with, you get a lot of rubbing. You get a lot of rubbing here if you're not lifted, so you can get rubbing in the back, and you can also get rubbing on the front. And then also, if you have, to make matters even more complicated, if you have a 2023 like I do, you could possibly be rubbing on the inside of these upper control arms. So I decided to go with the, like I said, so these are 265. I'll let you guys see. 265, 75, R16. Now this is gonna be a E rating tire. So this is, like, I believe is a, let me see if it says it on here. I think it's a 10 ply. I'm pretty sure these are 10 ply. Yeah. So 10 ply. So most of the tires, I believe, like, you know, like if you were to get like a Falcon Wild Peak, I believe those are like 6 ply or 4 ply or something like that. But these are like 10 ply. So these are really, really heavy duty. Typically, a lot of people don't like to put these a 10 ply on a mid-sized truck, but that's, you can't get them in a C rating for this size. So that was the thing too. So, like, you know, I had to really had a lot of things to consider when getting these tires. And also, I decided to go with the KO2s because I've had these before. To me, they're just like one of the best looking, they are the best looking AT tire. Just the aggressiveness on it. And I'm still a little on the fence. I'm still a little on the fence as far as the white lettering. I'm not gonna lie. I've always wanted to put it on the truck. I don't know. But the only thing I will say is, because before last night I was pretty much thinking, yeah, I think I made a mistake by putting these white letters out. The only thing that I kind of got going because is the white TRD. And I don't even know if it's white. It's probably silver. So, I don't know. You know, I'm just like, you know, I know my guy Untamed. You know, I watch Untamed. If you guys don't watch Untamed, check out his channel. He has a lot of Toyota Tacoma content and, you know, 4Runners, Tundras. He's got it all, Raptors. But, yeah, he does the white lettering out. So, I've always thought it would be cool, and I thought, you know, the orange and the white lettering, but I don't know, guys. We'll swing around. I just don't know yet. I think it looks good. I always wanted to do it. I like the lettering. I'm just not sure how good it looks. This is the darker side. We'll see how this shows up. But yeah. So I don't know. It looks good. I think it looks good. I'm looking at this side. Now, the only thing I got the tires at Discount Tire. So this video is kind of all over the place. I got the tires at Discount Tire. It was kind of like a whim, how it happened. I was watching YouTube and I was watching somebody talk about their 4Runner. I think the video was like, you know, some of the six first things to do to your 4Runner. And of course, one of the things was tires. And he started talking about his tires and where he got his tires from, and they were from Discount Tires. And he went into saying that he got a tire credit, because so when he first got the truck, the 4Runner, he went and got tires immediately. So he took the tires in and they gave him a credit for the tires. So, you know, that went towards his new tires. So I was like, what? You could do that? I was like, I would have been done did that a long time ago. You know what I'm saying? I would have did that a long time ago, but for whatever reason, I didn't. And so, yeah, they gave him a credit, and that's the only thing. Like, so, like, I had my tires. So I had the tires on that truck for, I can go in here and tell you for how long I actually had those tires on this truck. I had them on, I can tell you I had them on there since October of 22, like October 30th of 22. So, and I had about 7,000 miles, 7,000 and, you know, 690 miles. So they gave me $200. I really feel like, you know, that's my boy from school and everything. And, I feel like he hooked me up, but yeah, I think he could have hooked me up a little bit more. But you know, everybody, you always want more, right? Who's ever satisfied, right? Nobody, we're never satisfied. So I felt like I could have got more money. It's kind of like when you work, right? You always feel like you're worth more, right? Than what they're paying you. So yeah, so I got $200 and you know, the tires brand new are like $800. So, you know, I probably could have sold them on, that's what I, you know, thinking back now, maybe, you know, I could have tried to sell them, you know, because I'm pretty sure I could have got $400 or close to that. I could have easily got $350 for them. I know I could have if I would have posted them. What's up, Coco Bear? This is Cody Bryant. You just going to get on the camera and just start meowing? Yeah, so this is our Christmas kitty. She's got a twin brother named Samuel who went missing. You guys might have heard about that. But yeah, Cody, you're just going to be in the... All right, checking for mice, mices, or mouse, rats. But anyway, Cody just came and just ruined everything. But yeah, so where was I at before Cody came out here? So yeah, so you can take your tires in and exchange them and they'll, you know, put the money towards your new tires. So that's awesome. So they did a really good job. So as I was saying, the only thing that I didn't like that they didn't do, I don't think they did a good job. I don't think these center caps, I don't think these things are spinning inside there. So I'll probably go back because I don't know what they used. I'm gonna make sure all this stuff comes off. You know, make sure that they didn't scratch up anything, because that's one thing that I won't be happy with. So I am gonna clean up these wheels is what I'm gonna have to do. Clean up these wheels and make sure that they didn't scratch nothing up, unfortunately. But you know, I told them to take extra good care, of me. So hopefully that's not gonna be the case when I get these wheels cleaned up. So, you know, we'll go ahead and do that. But other than that, so yeah, so I don't know. I don't think those caps spin. I guess what I'll do is once I finish this video, and which should be pretty soon, I'll roll the truck up and see if those things move. Because, and what I'm saying is I want these, you know, another untamed thing, but I'm a little OCD too. I want it to be more lined up. I want the TRD center cap to be straight up, you know, straight across. TRD, you know, straight, you know, level, flat, you know, right side up. So I want them to all be right side up. So like on this side over here, see how it's like almost right side up? So I'm gonna drive the truck. I'm gonna move it forward and see if they move. You guys could do that with me, I guess, if you want to. We'll hop in the truck. Hopefully this thing doesn't try to like disconnect or do something stupid. If it does, then you guys know your video's over. It's nothing I can do. It's nothing more we can do, sir. Your video's over. I'm surprised to see if it'll let me even drive. It's gonna let me even drive with the door open. Okay. So much for all the Toyota safety sense, huh? Let's see what happened here. Let's see if we see if anything changed. Yeah, I don't think they're moving. Let me see. I don't know if they're moving or not. Do you guys know if they're moving? Let's see if they're moving. Make sure I put this thing in park because you guys know what happened. Okay, yeah, they are moving. So they are moving. You see how it's just like straight now? So I guess the only thing, let me turn this off. Oh, I guess I'll turn it a full lock for you guys. Let's get a full lock for you guys real quick, show you guys the inside. We got a beautiful day out here in the Northwest, Pacific Northwest, that is. So we'll do a full lock underneath here. kind of let you guys see what it looks like. So that's that full lock. We'll go the other way. Turn it the other way. Hopefully you guys are having a good weekend. Like I said, we're having some good weather out here. We are on our way to go feed the homeless today, or unhoused. So we're gonna go do that. So I tried to get in a good little video before we go do that. So let's turn it the other way and let's see. So yeah, so let me turn this off because it's just loud. This loud V8. This thing is just so loud, and it's a loud truck. But it's really not. But it was annoying for whatever reason, kind of like this beeping sound. So yeah, so I'll take you underneath here, see that Fox suspension, and kind of just go up. So this is the problem, what happens when you, when people are running 285s, they get to hitting that upper control arm up there. So they have to do spacers, wheel spacers. And I didn't want to run wheel spacers because I don't want to have to worry about the wheel flying off as you're going down the road, or having to keep on torquing them every single time you go get you rotate your tire. So I didn't want to do all that. And basically what I'm going to do is I just basically want it, so I'm always going to keep these wheels. So like, what most of the time what you'll do is probably, if you just have a TRD off-road or you have a sport, what you're going to do is you're going to upgrade your wheels and tires. So I am eventually going to upgrade my wheels, but I'm always going to keep my wheels because this is the TRD Pro. So this is the original equipment. So I didn't really care about keeping those tires. I didn't care about keeping the original tires. It would have been nice, but it was just a waste. So what I'm going to do is, if I can hurry up and get to my point, so I'm going to keep these for like my snow tires, my winter tires. So I'll keep these on the winter tires for the regular wheels. And then I'll get my 17-inch wheels for my summer tires, and I'm going to get mud terrain tires is what I want to do. So I'm going to get some 17-inch wheels, deep dish, and then I'll go 285s on those 17. So the next thing that I'm going to do is lift the truck. So I'm going to do the Westcott lift is the next thing that I want to do to the truck. So that'll be the next thing, and then we'll get the wheels and tires. So yeah, that's the route that I went, and I decided to go with the 265 75 because, like I said, I didn't want to rub and I didn't want to do spacers. And I never tried it, and I knew that it wasn't going to rub. So several people who have these trucks have put these tires on before, and they don't have a problem. And basically, it's like a half an inch. And you're going to have the same. So also, too, how I knew I wasn't really going to rub was because it's the same width. The 265, 70, and 75, it's the same exact width of the tire. So my width didn't change at all. So the only thing that changed was the, what do they call this? The tire height. I don't know if they call it curb height or whatever they call it, but the sidewall height is what they call it. So the sidewall height changed by a half an inch, basically. So that's going to do it. And I went with KO2s. The reason why I went with KO2s is because I like the way they look. And, you know, they're the Baja champions, you know. So they're the Baja champions. And they're the most aggressive looking tire, and I wanted the white lettering out, and I thought they looked good. I was going to do the Falcon Wall Peaks. They are a little bit wider, and that's kind of like what I was worried about, was I wanted to have a little bit more poke. But you're going to get more poke anyway when you get an aggressive tire. So even this is going to look better than what it looks stock, which is kind of hard to believe because I just had my tires all cleaned up and it, you know, all armor-alled, and it looked really good. I'm not even gonna lie. I was showing my buddy, and he's like, "No, these tires you got on here now look way better than what you had." And even at the shop, they said the same thing, that these look like, and now it looks like a real truck. So, I don't know. I'm just trying to adjust to the white lettering. So, we'll see. But the good thing about it being with the white lettering is I can always just, you know, switch them back around. So on the other side, you have the black lettering. So, we'll go and see how this does, and then you know, we'll get them, put some armor all on them, clean them up, clean up these wheels, and make sure they didn't scratch up anything. Cause that's gonna be something else that just, you know, I'm not gonna worry about it. You know, what can you do? You just clean up your wheels and take them back, and then they have to take care of you, you know? Because, you know, that's just how it goes. So, but no, they did a good job. So I hope that's not gonna be the case. Chopper. The chopper. But yeah, so truck is running good. Finally got something on it, and I'm happy with these tires. I went with the KO2s because I think they're the best looking AT tire that you can get, you know. So that's just what I think. So I went with these. Who knows if I'll go with them on the 285s after having these now. So I got the, you know, I got the white lettering out of my system, so to speak. So yeah, who knows what I'll go with on the 285s. But to me, picking your tires is like one of the biggest things. And this is the last thing I'll say for this long video, is when you are getting your tires, get the tires that you like. Don't get the tires that everybody else, you know, that everybody else likes, because then, you know, when you're looking at them, you're like, you might not like them. Like me with these tires right now with the white lettering. It's like, okay, yeah, it's cool, but it's might not be exactly what I like. This might not be, you know, because I like the tires alone. I like the pattern. So I don't necessarily have to have the white lettering out because I know what I got. Like to me, it's just a little too much. I don't know. It's just, I've seen it look good on some vehicles, but I don't know. I thought it would look better than it does. So yeah, you guys will probably see me switching this to black lettering out, because I just think with all the black accents and everything I like on the truck, it just doesn't make sense with the white lettering. It just doesn't make sense. So yeah, you guys seen it like this. It probably won't be like this very long. So thanks for checking out the channel. Have a good day and God bless. Have a great weekend. Peace.